In today's video, I'm gonna answer one of the most common questions I get. Does it get lonely living in a van full-time on the road? And if you stick around to the end, I'll give you a preview of one of the new additions to my van. Here's a little hint. Let's go. What is going on, YouTube? Greetings from my mom's property here in rural Missouri. I just got this really cool like chair. It's just a little like toadstool pedestal chair, but I really love it. I got it on Amazon. Let me just pull up a seat here. Today's video is going to be about loneliness. Let me start this off by saying there's a difference between being alone and being lonely. Yes, sometimes I am alone in my van. Sometimes by choice, sometimes it just works out that way. I think you're gonna be pretty surprised to hear I'm very much an introvert. Every personality test I've ever taken, I always lean heavily towards the introverted side when I get the results back. As an introvert, I get my energy from being alone, so being alone doesn't really bother me that much. That doesn't mean I don't like being around people or being social. I actually love being around people. Being alone is just where I personally get my energy from. So some of the time, I'm alone by choice. Other times, I'm kind of forced to be alone because I just end up in places where there aren't that many people. But the great thing about this lifestyle, if that starts to wear on me, I can just hop in my van and go somewhere else. Okay, so let's talk about why solo RV living hasn't been lonely for me and why it isn't lonely for most people. Reason number one, you get to meet a ton of people with similar interests. Whether you're camping on BLM land and national forest land, or you're camping at campsites, you're going to find people that enjoy living in a van, RVing, camping, all that kind of stuff. You immediately have something in common with that person, and it makes talking to them pretty easy. The biggest way I've connected with people is through groups. I'm a member of two groups, the Escapers and the Winnie Bee Association, and I've hung out with a ton of Escapers, and I've hung out with a ton of Winnie Bee people. There are so many RV groups out there specifically designed for solo travelers. No matter what your interests, no matter what kind of solo traveler you are, whether you're in a van, a bus, whatever it is, you're gonna be able to find a group that is part of that niche. If you know any, make sure you link them below and I'll make sure that link gets posted. If you're enjoying this video, please hit that thumbs up button and leave a comment below telling me where you're watching from. The YouTube algorithm will show this video to more people the more thumbs up and the more comments I have. So I appreciate you doing that. Also, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of my weekly videos. The second way I've been able to avoid loneliness is there are a lot of brief encounters in this lifestyle. You're on the go, you're in your van, finding BLM parking spots, parking at a Cracker Barrel, going to a campground, going on hikes, doing all the things that we do as full-time RVers. And you're gonna run into people on the hiking trail, you're gonna run into people on BLM land, and you have these brief encounters where you have a little chat, talk about where you've been, where you're going, where they've been, where they're going, get recommendations for campgrounds, things like that. So you're interacting with people almost on a daily basis in this lifestyle. You're not holed up in the middle of the woods somewhere, although some people might like that, but that's not really the reality of the lifestyle. It's really a very social lifestyle if you want it to be that. What's really great about the group encounters or the chance encounters is a lot of these people end up becoming lifelong friends. Whether it's interacting in the groups I discussed earlier, random meetups from a dating app or in campgrounds, or even meeting some YouTube subscribers, I've been really fortunate to meet a ton of people that have become what I consider good friends. I like to share my location with my travel friends. So if you look at my Google Maps, I have friends from remote year, friends from RVing, friends from the military, scattered all throughout my Google Maps. And it's a really cool tool to be able to meet up with them and figure out if we're gonna be in the same area. Okay, so the third reason I don't get lonely on the road is because many full-time nomads, including myself, have something others do not: time. This one is huge, I think. Many full-time RVers and van lifers just have more time than most people, so it's easier to connect with them, to hang out, to go for a hike, to do different things. Most aren't limited to just the weekends. We can hang out during the week. When I'm with the escapers, there's always something to do. There's a hike to go on, a bike ride to go on, a meal to join, a bonfire to go hang out at it in the evening. There's always something to do because we just have more time. So it's great to meet a bunch of people that have time to hang out. And on that same note, the fourth reason is it's allowed me to have more frequent visits with friends and family. This one is really big for me. I spent 20 years in the military and I have hundreds of friends scattered throughout the country. Some of them I haven't seen in 25 years. There's almost always a military buddy along the route I'm traveling. So that has been pretty awesome. Same thing with other friends and family. You recently saw that I boondocked in Breckenridge and then I boondocked in Lake Tahoe. I stayed with remote year travel friends and that was pretty amazing to get to spend time with them and reconnect after our 1 year of travel in 2019. And look at me right now. I'm parked here on my mom's land. I get to hang out with her. When I was in the military and I was a corporate lawyer, I might make it home once a year, but now I come home 3, 4, 5, 6 times a year, probably driving my mom insane to be completely honest with you. She's probably ready to evict me off her property, but that part of it's been really great. I've been able to spend more time with my family. To me, this has been the biggest benefit of full-time RVing. I've been able to reconnect with old friends and spend more time with family. All right, here are a few other suggestions for beating loneliness on the road. If COVID has taught us anything, we can use Zoom and FaceTime to reconnect with friends and family and even do business. So if you're the kind of person that needs to talk to someone every single night, just hop on a Zoom call, hop on a FaceTime call, and you'll be able to itch that scratch. The next tip is get a pet. I always joke that I'm probably the only person that spent 20 years in the Navy and doesn't have a tattoo. I have a similar claim in the RV community. I'm probably the only RVer or van lifer that does not have a pet. Almost everybody on the road has a pet, and that's another good way to beat that loneliness bug. The last tip is get a van or get an RV that's big enough to take people with you sometimes. I'm sure you have friends and family that would love to join you on a trip to the mountains, to the ocean, hiking, skiing, mountain biking, camping for a couple weeks, whatever it is, you can probably get someone to join you in your van. Heck, if you'd like to join me in my van, type down below in the comments. I'd love to come out camping with you, Kevin, and maybe I'll let you use the spare bed in my van. So being on the road has been the exact opposite of lonely for me. I'm actually a lot more social than I was before when I was a corporate lawyer working 15, 18 hours a day, crammed in an office. All right, let me give you a little teaser for next week's video. So this is the new edition, a 2020 Honda Grom. Make sure you tune in next week and I'll tell you how I'm gonna carry it on my van and why I bought this thing. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that thumbs up button. And if you enjoy content like this, I make a weekly video, make sure you hit that subscribe button and hit that little notification bell. I'll send you an email when I put out a video. Thanks for watching.